Hello and welcome everyone. In the last video, we have seen how the login and sign up APIs are working. We are able to test them and we are seeing that based on the valid payload, we are able to register and sign in. And from the sign in, we are getting the token. So now in this video, we are going to add authorization layer, and authorization is just about that whenever you are hitting any protected the APIs or like you are doing change in a data in the database, then that API should be protected, and we are protecting those APIs through the token. So if you are just sending a token with that API, then first we are authenticating that user is valid or not. Then we can also add another layer of authorization based on the role. We will be just checking the role, okay, this user is allowed or not. For that, we are going to write authorization.js, another resolver. .js, and here we will write our common methods. So here we are going to write a custom kind of a middleware. Okay, so there is no such concept of middleware. What we do is we actually create a resolver and we combine both the resolvers. So first resolver will do the validation, second will fetch the data, first will validate the token, second will validate the role, and third will fetch the data for the mutation and query. Okay, so what we can do is we will getting the combined resolvers from the GraphQL resolver. So here we will get two things, combined resolvers, and here we can write our methods, export const, is authenticated. Okay, in authenticated it means we are going to check that this user is holding the token or not. Okay, so every this is going to accept the same kind of argument which every resolver is accepting, parent and arguments, comma, here we are providing the models, comma, and me. So we don't need models because we are not going to make any API call. But before going here, I will try to show you one single thing. In our previous videos, we have done this, like if his user is logged in and user is holding this token, X token, then we were validating the token through this method, and we were assigning me equal to the payload of user if user is logged in and the user is sending this token value in the request. Okay, this is already being done. So this property we are already having in the context. So what we can do is, before sending this request to the mutation, we can just check if me property exists, me object, me having user object exists. That means user is authenticated. We are sending this X token in the header, and now his user is authenticated. This token is valid, not expired. Otherwise, we will be getting an authentication error. Okay, so if you just see the authorization here, we can just simply check. I mean, we don't need to do anything here. We can just write it in a single line also, but let's write it. If me is not null, if me has some value, then we can just return skip. It means you have the data. Otherwise, what we will do is we will return new forbidden exception, or you can say the throw. New forbidden error. User is not authenticated, whatever. Okay, this is the first method. Another method can be export const is admin. Like if a particular user is holding a role admin, then we can do this. So here we are going to check first user is authenticated or not, right? So in that case, we will be using combined resolver. So first resolver is authenticated, and now second resolver is the same, where we will be passing all these arguments, parent arguments, and here I will be getting the me property, and from me property also I will be accessing the role. Okay, and let me just check what is this. And here if you just check that here we can return if role equal to admin, then you can skip. Otherwise again here we will be returning new forbidden error, user is not authorized for this operation, something like this. Okay, things are clear now. Do we have any additional brackets? Let me just check. Yeah, so we have created these two methods and we are exporting them. So we'll be importing these two methods, isAuthenticated and isAdmin, in our user mutation. And in the user mutation, mutations of user, in some cases like where we are updating and deleting the user, there we can use this combined resolver. So import combined resolver from Apollo, GraphQL resolvers, and here. So we'll be combining the resolvers for these two operations. It should go in the resolvers, and we also need to import authentications and all from authorization. Is admin and is authenticated, both the property, and we are going to use combined resolver for both these operations, update user and delete user. So how you do it? I think we can just create a bracket, and it will take two arguments. First of all, combined resolver is authenticated, let's say is admin, okay, and next is this whole function. Okay, this worked. Similarly, we have to combine the resolvers for delete also. Delete user, combine resolver. Here the first resolver will be is admin. I mean, both are allowed for admin only. So this is how you can add the authorization layer for some of your APIs, where combined resolver is admin is the first resolver. If you are able to move forward without throwing any exception, then only this will be get processed. So here in both the methods we are checking the role of user, and role is we are accessing from the me property. So how actually the whole flow is working, you will be passing the X token. So okay, and in the me property you will get the whole user object, because this method is just verifying the token and returning the payload. So this me property will hold the user object having the role, username, password. While doing a sign up, sign in, we are creating this token. You can see the user token, and user has this email, password, username and token. So we are creating the token from that, this method. We are passing these four properties in the token payload. So while we verify it, we will get this data back, and we are assigning that to the me property, and this me property will be available. So this authorization we have added, if me property is there, it means this is authenticated. You can do the next, which is same as skip. Same for the admin role, if the current user logged in user role is admin, then allow him, otherwise send a forbidden error message. Okay, so this is how you can add an authorization layer in your APIs, GraphQL APIs. You can just combine the resolvers, and based on some attribute on the user session data, you can just check if user is logged in, user is authorized to do this particular operation or particular mutation, or maybe executing a particular query. Okay, that's it. Thanks everyone. So next videos I will be publishing after some time, which will be module 02. Here we will introduce other set of entities also, like you can say user has a post, post has a comment. So we'll have a three different Mongoose modules, Mongoose models, and we will define the associations, and we will be fetching the data accordingly, and based on that we'll be writing the queries and mutation for all different entities. Like here we have for the message, so here we will be creating a resolver for the post and comments. Here we will be defining the schema for the post and comments, and then we'll be just writing the mutations and queries. Okay, thanks everyone.